All right. So, like we were talking about, Mr. Jenkins, a significant difference between Let's Eat Grandma, direct address, and Let's Eat Grandma. Is there not? Okay. Come on up. Talk about Jane Eyre now that we're done, and share with the class.
Okay.
Jane is a girl. Jane likes to read. She lives with her aunt and her three cousins. Aunt Reed is a hypocritical woman who treats Jane harshly. Cousins John, Eliza, and Georgiana hate Jane. One day, John hits Jane with her book. They fight. Aunt Reed sends Jane to the Red Room. She thinks she sees the ghost of her Uncle Reed. She is very afraid. She faints. When she wakes up, the apothecary, Mr. Lloyd, asks her if she wants to go to school. She says yes. Mr. Brocklehurst visits Jane. He is the headmaster of Lowood School. He asks Jane questions. Jane answers. Mr. Brocklehurst is disappointed. Aunt Reed tells Mr. Brocklehurst that Jane is deceitful. Mr. Brocklehurst leaves. Jane yells at her aunt. Jane wins. Bessie, a servant, tells Jane stories. When Jane leaves to school, Bessie tells Jane that she actually liked her the whole time. How sweet. Jane arrives at Lowood. It sucks slightly less than her aunt's house. She meets a girl named Helen. Helen is very smart. They become friends. Helen teaches Jane Christianity. Jane drops her slate. Mr. Brocklehurst is mad. He makes Jane stand on a stool. The girls feel bad for Jane. Jane becomes friends with the teacher, Miss Temple. Jane, Helen, and Miss Temple have tea. The school becomes infected with typhus. Jane does not get sick, but finds out that Helen has consumption. They fall asleep together. Helen dies. Sad clown. For the next 6 years, Jane excels in her studies. 6 years later, Jane is a teacher at Lowood. Mr. Brocklehurst is gone. The school is a lot better. After 2 more years, Miss Temple gets married and leaves the school. Jane is sad. Jane decides to become a governess. Before Jane leaves to her new job at Thornfield, Bessie comes and visits Jane. Jane learns that Georgiana Reed tried to run away with a lord. Eliza ruined it for Georgiana by telling Aunt Reed. What a tattletale. John is a wreck and is not very stable. Bessie tells Jane that a man named John Eyre, Jane's uncle, came looking for Jane 7 years before. Jane and Bessie say goodbye again. Parting is such a sweet sorrow. Jane leaves to Thornfield and meets Mrs. Fairfax, the housekeeper. Jane's job is to teach a young girl named Adele. Jane hears a horrific laugh from somewhere in the house and is frightened. Mrs. Fairfax introduces Jane to Grace Poole, who is assumed to be the source of the laughter. For some reason, Jane likes Thornfield. At night, Jane helps a man who falls off of his horse. The man has very dark features and is older than her. Upon returning to Thornfield, Jane learns that this is Mr. Rochester, the owner of the house. The next day, Jane and Adele have tea with Mr. Rochester. Jane draws for him. She's an artful adventurer. Mrs. Fairfax mentions Rochester's troublesome history. How strange. Later, Mr. Rochester is in his after-dinner mood. He sends for Jane and Adele. He gives Adele a present. Then he chats with Jane. Do you think me handsome? No, sir. Burn. Rochester is obviously drunk. Jane feels awkward. Adele mentions her mother. Rochester explains the next morning. He had a relationship with Adele's mom. She cheated on him. They broke up. Why do relationships end this way? Adele was abandoned, so Rochester took her to England. Jane can't sleep. She hears the creepy laugh. Again. When she leaves her room, she sees smoke coming from Mr. Rochester's room. Rochester's bed is on fire. Jane saves his life. Yippee! Jane thinks Grace Poole lit the fire. Rochester goes to the third floor. When he comes back, he says that it was Grace who did it. Rochester says, don't tell. Jane's lips are sealed. Jane wakes up. Everything is normal. Jane is confused. Why does Rochester keep Grace around? Jane finds that she has a crush on Rochester. He goes away to see a woman named Blanche Ingram. Blanche is real eye candy. Jane is disappointed that she is plain. Rochester is gone for a whole week. Jane hears that Rochester might go to Europe and that he might be gone longer. She also hears that Grace gets paid a lot of money. Rochester comes back with some friends. Jane joins them, but she feels awkward amidst them. Blanche is mean to Jane. When Jane tries to leave, Rochester stops her, but lets her go. Rochester tells Jane to go to the drawing room every morning and then says, good night, my. Rochester likes Jane back. Maybe. Possibly. It's hard to tell. A gypsy shows up and reads Jane's fortune. Jane is entranced. The gypsy tells Jane that she is close to happiness and that Rochester is not as rich as he seems. The gypsy knows a lot. What a creeper. It turns out that the gypsy is Rochester. OMG! He tricked her. Jane tells Rochester that Mr. Mason arrived at Thornfield. Rochester seems troubled. At night, Jane hears a scream. Rochester tells his guests that a servant had a nightmare. Lies. The guests go back to bed. Rochester comes into Jane's room. You don't turn sick at the sight of blood? I think I shall not. I have never been tried yet. They go to the third floor. Mr. Mason is injured because he was attacked. He was the one who screamed. Jane stays with Mr. Mason while Rochester goes to get a surgeon. He takes forever. When Rochester comes back, he sends Mr. Mason away with the surgeon. Later in the morning, Rochester and Jane take a stroll. Very cute. Rochester tells Jane a story about a man who committed a capital error. The man is Rochester. Who knew? Rochester says that he wants to obtain relief by marrying. Jane dreams about children for a whole week. That's a bad sign. Jane learns that John Reed committed suicide and that Aunt Reed is dying, so she goes to Gateshead. Eliza and Georgiana are on bad terms with one another, but no longer with Jane. Aunt Reed is still an unpleasant woman. She withheld a letter from Jane. The letter is from John Eyre saying that he wanted to adopt Jane. Using what Helen taught her, Jane is nice about the incident and tries to fix her relationship with Aunt Reed. Aunt Reed refuses. How inhumane. Aunt Reed dies that night. Very sad. Not really. Jane leaves Gateshead and sees Rochester. He has a new carriage. She really, really likes him. Aw. They go back to Thornfield. 2 weeks later, Jane and Rochester walk in the garden. Rochester says that he will marry Blanche. That means Jane will have to leave. They sit under a chestnut tree together. Jane confesses her love to Rochester. He asks her to marry him. What a strange turn of events. After Rochester assures Jane that he is not joking, she says yes. Hooray! That night, lightning strikes and cleaves the tree under which the proposal occurred. That's a bit creepy. Preparations for the upcoming wedding do not go well. Mrs. Fairfax seems to disapprove, and Jane feels uneasy. Jane sends her feelings about the wedding to John Eyre in a letter. At night, Jane thinks she sees a savage woman tear her wedding veil. She also has weird dreams. The next day, Jane and Rochester go to their wedding. The priest asks whether anyone objects to the marriage. Someone objects. It is Mr. Briggs who represents Mr. Mason. He reveals that Rochester is already married. That no good polygamist. Rochester's wife is Bertha Mason and Mr. Mason's sister. Bertha is a crazy woman that Rochester locked away. The woman who tore up Jane's wedding veil. They go to see Bertha, who acts like a beast. Jane is distraught. Poor girl. Rochester is sorry. Jane forgives him. Rochester wants to run away. Jane says no. Rochester explains his past. Bertha was rich. Rochester thought that he was in love. They married. Bertha was insane, so Rochester locked her away. Jane is a very confused girl. That night, Jane dreams that her mother tells her to flee. She takes her stuff and leaves Thornfield. Jane spends all her money on a coach ride. She sleeps outdoors. She must be pretty desperate at this point. In a nearby town, Jane begs for food and work. She is not so lucky. She happens upon a house on the moors in which people take her in. The people are siblings. St. John, Mary, and Diana Rivers. Mary and Diana are governesses, and St. John is a missionary. Their father, Mr. Rivers, died recently. Mr. Rivers lost the family fortune to Uncle John. Uncle John also died recently and left his fortune to an unknown relative. Very suspicious. Jane lies about her surname. My name is Jane Elliot. St. John gets Jane a job at Morton, a charity school for girls. Rosamond Oliver is a wealthy heiress. She gives Jane a place to stay. St. John likes Rosamond but refuses to take her as a wife. Jane initially hates her job, but she begins to like her students. However, she has troubling dreams at night, again. While Jane is drawing, St. John notices her signature. It says Jane Eyre. Jane and the Rivers are cousins. Uncle John left his fortune for Jane. Cha-ching! Jane shares her money with her cousins. Jane closes Morton School for Christmas. Over vacation, St. John tells Jane that Rosamond is engaged. After time, St. John proposes to Jane. She says no. St. John continues to pressure Jane to become his wife. The answer is still no. Later that week, Jane hears a voice calling her. It's Rochester's voice.
Ooh.
Jane leaves to Thornfield. When she gets there, she finds Thornfield in ruins. It was burned down by Bertha. Bertha is dead. Rochester's blind and is missing a hand. Rochester's in Ferndene. Jane goes to Ferndene. Jane sees Rochester from a distance. Jane knocks on the door. Mary and John, two servants, answer the door. Pretending to be one of the servants, Jane brings Rochester food. Rochester realizes that it is Jane and they embrace. Jane promises to never leave Rochester again. Very touching. Jane and Rochester go walking in the woods and get caught up on the last year. Rochester asks Jane to marry him again. Yes, sir. Jane and Rochester have a private wedding. Jane tells her cousins about the marriage in a letter. St. John does not acknowledge, but Mary and Diana wish Jane the best. Jane visits Adele and puts her in a good school. They grow to be good friends. Jane and Rochester have a baby boy. Rochester is happy that he can barely see the baby. Mary and Diana both get married. The story ends with St. John predicting his death. Very odd.